Sports mad Sarah is a size 20 and is 11 months away from marrying fiancé Dylan.
We used to go to the same Tuesday night running club. I was in the intermediate group and Sarah was in the not so intermediate group, really.
Yeah, the beginner, the slow-mo group.
Although her performance on the track has improved, she's lagging behind when it comes to fashion.
Sport's always been quite a big part of my life. I've always been into running, but when it comes to being girly and pretty that way, I struggle.
To help her reconnect to her passion for fashion, she's brought Nan Mora and Mum Angela.
Hello, Sarah.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh,
look at
lovely
you.
Colour. That's my favourite colour.
That's my favourite colour.
Oh. You're a bit of a sporty person.
Yeah, a little bit.
Just,
yeah.
You know, can't run give it away.
Yeah, run. Can I just run? That's a good. Yeah. So if I can run in my dress, that'd be even better.
I'll be in sports kit for running and doing sport. Otherwise, I'm in jeans and a hoodie.
So on your wedding day, you want to feel slightly different. How do you want to feel?
I just want to feel girly. I want to be a princess.
I tell you what, you're going to be so surprised at how you actually look in a dress, you won't even recognise yourself.
Once we can convince her that she can look feminine, I think we're three quarters of the way there.
That's just a no. It's too white. It's got sleeves. And it's, ooh.
It's good to come to people who empathise and kind of understand how nervous it is to go and try and find a dress to be the centre of attention.
Sparkly, like elf princess. That's going up.
Right, Sarah, are we ready to start getting some dresses on?
Let's try.
Yeah?
Yeah. I'm not going to get stuck, am I?
No, of course you're not going to get stuck.
Sure this is going to fit?
Yes, I'm absolutely 100% positive.
Sarah thinks she's this great big giant who's 10 foot tall and 10 foot wide, and in actual fact, she's really not. I just want her to see herself as we see her.
OK, ladies, open your eyes. And you.
Oh, wow. A dress.
Yeah. I'm not spilling out over it.
I don't look like I've squeezed myself into it like a sausage. It fits.
Nice, beautiful.
So much of my life, nothing's ever fit. You know, I love fashion, but it's not something I can enjoy or take part in. So I just watch from the outside. It's the first time I've been able to enjoy trying things on and, you know, dressing up.
You look incredible.
It's lots of sparkles.
There is lots of sparkles.
Sparkles. I like all this bit here. But I think there's still scope to try others on.
Let's take that one off.
Nothing
then.
Nothing for you then.
As a child, she was always in dungarees and barefooted and just a tomboy, really.
I've never really seen Sarah dressed up very often.
Yes. She says that she's quite big, but she's not.
Right, OK, I'm coming in, Sarah.
First hurdle's done. Now it's just finding something that makes her feel feminine.
You absolutely had to try this one on. What is it about it that you like, Sarah?
I think it's everything that I always thought a wedding dress should be.
Just you. Open your eyes and... Okay, ladies, you can open your eyes.
I like it. And it's flattering the V down there, symmetrical.
It's got a bit of bling.
Blingy.
Yeah, it's got a bit
but
bling.
Not too much.
Do you feel feminine?
Yeah, I feel girly. I feel like a princess.
It was like, I'm this princess that I wanted to be, and almost disbelief that she was looking at herself in the mirror. And that's lovely when that happens.
Yeah, I have my necklace.
She's smiling, Jo.
She is smiling.
My something new.
And this is the first time, really, that she's smiled and looked relaxed.
Yeah, it's pretty. I think it might just be my dress.
I feel like spinning round.
Sarah's gone from thinking that she looks like a tomboy to being a princess twirling around the room in tulle. What a journey.
Oh. I'm feeling relieved I've got a dress. I need to go get married now. So heels and a dress. I'd have to practice walking. But I'm sure Jo and Al, they'll be able to help, I'm sure. I hope.
It's the big day for Dylan and Sarah. And oblivious to the wet conditions, the bride, who sees herself as an unfeminine athlete, is suffering from pre-race nerves.
I just want to get my dress on, get down the stairs with feminine grace. You know, like Miss Congeniality, I need Michael Caine teaching me how to walk.
In lieu of Michael Caine, the epitome of gracefulness, Jo and Al, are arriving to apply the finishing touches.
She's going to feel a little bit like a duck out of water. Pardon the pun.
Yes, indeed. It could tip her right over the edge.
But in another part of the hotel, the groom is looking forward to seeing his fiancée in something other than a hoodie and joggers.
All good this morning. The dress has been top secret, so it's going to be a complete surprise when she joins me at the end of the aisle.
Hello, hello.
Hi.
Hello.
Oh my goodness.
You look so different to when we first met you.
I hope that's a good thing.
Oh yeah, you look beautiful.
Yes, you do.
Thank you.
How do you feel with all the makeup on and your hair?
I feel girly.
I feel girly?
Yeah.
But wasn't that the whole idea?
I keep looking in the mirror and going, ooh, who's that? And it's me. It's like that bit before a race. You're kind of in your own bubble, and you just go, right, it's go time.
Sarah, are you ready to see yourself?
Yes.
Come on, then, have a look.
Ooh. Pretty.
You look beautiful.
Thank you.
Feel very proud, don't we, Jo?
Yes. You look amazing.
Just look amazing.
Thank you.
You're allowed to cry.
I want some of my makeup on my mouth.
That's okay, she's still here.
What a transformation.
I know, it's immense.
You just look fabulous.
Thank you, ladies.
Welcome. How different.
What do I need to do?
Get married.
Yes.
Get married, come on, let's go.
I always thought I'd get married, but I never thought anyone would want to marry me. But, you know, we've found Dylan and he's all right. He thinks I'm all right, so, you know. Being married just kind of completes the circle, doesn't it?
Bride on the run. OK.
You got this. Own it as you walk down there and just savour it all.
Bit I'm most looking forward to, I think, is seeing the look on her face. When I looked down that aisle and she stood there with the dad, I think, yeah, it's going to be great. I don't detect thee, Sarah Louise, to be my lawful wedded wife.
I, Sarah Louise, detect thee to be my lawful wedded husband.
Sarah and Dylan, it's with great pleasure I declare you husband and wife. Congratulations.
The dress is incredible. And fair play to the girls in the boutique. They did say that you chose it straight off the bag, mm-hmm. No help, so, yeah, you look amazing.
It's so lovely to see the difference in Sarah today, isn't it?
Absolutely. She was very boy-like when we first met her, you know, with her jeans and her baggy sweatshirt. Everything now is different.
I mean, the makeup and the hair and the veil. I was like, who is this person?
There was the epitome of a feminine princess.